Thank you very much for attending my session. And my name is Somsak, and I'm coming from my company called ByteArk. Okay. Deep breath. Okay. Today I will talk about how we adopt the open source and how it helped us in the time of a little bit of a crisis that we faced last year to scale. Actually, it scaled 4 times. after I finished the slide, I found out that at the end of the event, we actually scaled about a little bit more than four times within 2 months, not 5 times, sorry. Yeah, but because I compare it to the current capacity that we have, it is actually right now we have 5 times compared to that event. Okay, so because we have a lot of non-disclosure agreement NDA with so many partners, so many customers, so I don't even sure what we can reveal in the slides. So most of the names will be hidden or maybe modified to be something not so easy to guess. So don't panic if you see the name of the ISP in the form of some kind of animal or something like that. Okay, so what we are doing, ByteArk, my company is providing the CDN content delivery network. Infrastructure is a kind of the cloud services that offer the people who want to distribute the content, I mean, put something for the customer to load from the web or something like that. So the most prominent use case of the CDN is to be used in the video streaming because one gigabit per second server usually can only contain about 400 viewers of the HD, not full HD, just HD, which is a very, very small figure for the expectation of most of our customers. Most of our customers usually told us that they want millions viewers at the same time. Well, actually, there never be any single event that have achieved 1 million. Combined, yes, maybe, but no, for the single event. Yeah. So in most cases, if you want to do the video streaming in this country, you will usually need some kind of CDN, either buying the services from us or from our competitors, or maybe build the CDN by yourself. You have no choice. You cannot use a single server to serve the video streaming in not large scale, just medium scale. It's not possible anymore. I just want to give some background of what the CDN is actually doing. In most cases, we have the edge server running in most of the in internet services provider in Thailand, and when the client, I mean client of our customer, requests from something from the server, our edge server will fetch that content from the origin server and cache it in our server. The next request, if the new client requests the same thing, the request will not coming through to the origin server, so the bandwidth used by the origin server will be much less, especially if the content is some kind of like live streaming, where everyone view the same thing, the same content, the same video streaming, yeah, that will be a lot of saving on the origin side. So this is our tech stack, so just to give you some idea that we use a lot of open sources. Actually, this is the current tech stack, but what I'm talking about is this is our distribution of the CDN node worldwide, and this is what I will focus today. This is the current capacity that we have about a little bit more than 1,000 gigabit per second capacity to serve the video streaming in Thailand. This is now, but actually, what I would like to talk about, focus about in today is the event that happened around 2018, around February. At that time, we have about 200 gigabit per second. And this is the capacity that we have at the time. So what happened in just 1 year? Actually, we have a major customer that has a TV program that has gained a lot of viral attention from the internet. And the customer has come, talk to us via line, the line application, and warned us that this program could gain a lot of traction, a lot of viewers to view the video streaming. So this for the information, this is a kind of like 8 to 10 episodic program. So it's not just the one time event. It's continued for about 2 months. So okay, so this is not the first time that we received this kind of the warning from the customer. So okay, we see that we have 200 at that time. So the first episode of this TV program, I have to hide the timeline, because if you see the date and time, you know exactly what actually this is. The first episode, we got about 50 gigabit per second. I mean, this translated into about 50,000 concurrent viewers at the same time. This is quite large, but not that very large. Not that very large. Okay. So at the time, we still feel relaxed and thinking that, well, this is not that too much to handle. Okay, it's quite large at the time. It took about 25% of our capacity, but it's not too much to handle. And we actually, our team, that time, I think it's Wednesday, and our team still thinking about hanging out in Friday night, making an appointment. And the second episode, we see the bandwidth go up to about 100. Do you see the sharp decline here? It happened because the infrastructure of our customer, because we provide the CDN, our customer provide the application and website to put the streaming into it. So at that time, our customer's application and website both down because a lot of viewers coming in and getting to their website, and their website down, which is actually it saved our asses, frankly speaking, because the traffic is so much that it's much more than we anticipated at that time. The maximum bandwidth that happened is about 120 gigabit, which is about 120,000 concurrent viewers, about that, yeah. 120, 150, something. So at that time, what happened? We start to experience a little bit of hiccups in our servers, because we cache the content, right? And most of the time, there will be some kind of content that cannot be cached, because it's just being generated. If it's a live streaming, video streaming, the new content will be generated every about 5 or 6 seconds. And usually some loads will come and hit the origin server, and that usually is about 1%. But for 1% of the 120 gigabit per second is more than 1 gigabit per second. So that is too much to handle for the origin server. And yeah, that as I mentioned, luckily the app and website of our customer also experienced the technical problem, and it went down. So the amount of the bandwidth used is not going up after that. And at that time, we quickly engineer a way to even make the caching process happen more quickly for the load that coming through to the origin server is going down to about, I think, maybe 0.01%. And we cancel all the plans at that weekend. okay, at this time, we start to think about the increasing the capacity. We plan, we contact the vendors, hardware, something like that, and we try to negotiate the way to quickly expand a kind of like temporary infrastructure to accommodate the load. Some of you might think that why don't we use maybe something like public cloud, or maybe use something like Amazon CloudFront or something like that to provide the services. I would say that if we use that, it can cost like maybe $1 million per episode, $1 million baht, I think. Yeah, that is too much cost for our customer and for us too. So if possible, we don't really want to use that in the first place. So we try to optimize our infrastructure first. And this is the third episode, which is a week after the second episode. The third episode, we feed a double again for each episode, double. So we now are quite around a quadruple concurrent in just the third episode. And don't forget that it's actually about 8 to 10 episodes TV program. So it's not halfway yet, and we have seen 212.18 gigabit per second in our system. So yeah, we really panic because at the time we only have about 220 gigabit per second capacity. So what happened? This is okay for the record. This is the first time in the history of our customer also that TV program has gained a lot of traction in just a short amount of time. Usually, okay, some of these kind of TV program may gain a lot of traction, but that will be almost near the end of the TV program, maybe at episode 7, 8, not episode 3. So we contact all the internet data center that we know of. We are that we are also their customers to have a kind of like temporary dark space and bandwidth, and negotiate the price, of course. And we got about 25% more rack space, more bandwidth that we can put the server in and scale immediately. So, and the next thing we do is that we buy a lot of servers. That is the nice thing about the OneSource, because we don't really need to do something like compliance test or something like that. We can buy anything that is x86-64 server, and we even looking for the second-hand server, anything that can run our software, because all the stack that we are doing is based on the open source. And okay, we also found that the origin server is load a lot again. So we engineered a way to broadcast the video streaming, the live video streaming to all the edge server at the same time. So the load to the origin server is very, 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 very little. And at the same time, our customer also experienced some technical problem. It went down again. And for the record, they use the public cloud, one of the very famous public cloud. And this is the fourth episode, which is the next day after the third episode. And we see the new record again. We see 250 gigabit per second. That is about 260,000 concurrent viewers at the same time. Yes. And this is the first time that we see the scale, we just see the scale, but not reaching it yet, of the 300 gigabit per second for the single event. Okay, so this day, this is the first day that our customers' infrastructure is not went down, because they scale. I think they scale to about 100 of servers in their public cloud to cover for the load. Yeah, And we also finish increasing 25% of capacity that we deal with our IDCs the day before, and we expand it within the single day. Because we use Ansible, we use the DevOps things like that to accommodate the expansion, so we can quickly increase the capacity very fast. And this is the first day that we have to remove some of the resolution. I mean, because in the live streaming this day, we usually ship with the multiple resolution. They call it adaptive bitrate. We have at that time we have the HD, the 720p resolution, which is the highest resolution that we provide for this TV program, and we have the FD, the 480p. Resolution. So we negotiate with our customer to remove the highest one to save some bandwidth. And actually, the bandwidth is not the very serious problem at that time. The very serious problem at that time is actually the processing overhead that occurs because the HTTPS. Because at that time, HTTPS is being widely adopted because of the coming of the lattice encrypt certificate and the enforcing policy from many browsers like Chrome and Firefox. So a lot of people using HTTPS. So after the fourth episode, we have about a week, about 4 or 5 days, because we cannot scale out until the last second. We have to do it, and we have to test. So we have only about 4 or 5 days to scale the system to cover the load that, well, if it double at every episode, it means that at the next week, at least we need 400 or 500 gigabit per second to capacity to accommodate for the concurrent viewer. And this time we do not have to contact anyone because all the major internet service provider in Thailand contact us because they all the peering, because in the internet is actually a web of the connection between each other, right? And at that time, I think we already exhausted all the peering of the internet service, all the internet service provider. So they are really panicked also. So they contact us to have our servers being put in their IDC. So the traffic is not coming out. For example, if you use True, the traffic will be limited only inside the True network or something like that. If you use the DTAC, for example, the traffic will be limited inside only the local network. So yeah, we get a lot of rack space, we get a lot of bandwidth at the time, but we don't have enough the server. So instead of so we took over the server from our friends who just went out of the business. they did the public cloud kind of things like that business, and they kind of like when things not going well, and they went out of the business. So we took all of their servers. I think it's about 30 or 50 servers to be used as the CDN servers at the time. Oops, sorry. So after this batch, we have a capacity up to about 500 gigabits. And the next episode, fifth episode, yeah, we see 450 gigabit capacity. So this program make a new record every episode, and every episode at the sixth episode, we see the 600 gigabit per second. Yeah, you see that the graph is not capped, so it's not reaching the top limit yet, but the number is very very surprising because it like double at every week. So after the fifth episode, the thing kind of like the recurring task, we expand it because now we have kind of like almost unlimited rack space in almost all the internet services provider in Thailand. So we expand every week and until we ran out of money or something, something like that. Yeah. We buy a lot of server every week and put in every ISP as much as we can. So after the sixth episode, we beginning to get about 700 gigabit per second capacity to cover this event. Okay, and because we have the time constraint of the presentation, right? So I would like to fast forward to the last episode because after that, the capacity is about the same. The thing is that I think we already cover maybe all of the possible viewer in Thailand already. The people who should watch this TV program already come and watch it. It's about the maximum capacity that we have is about at that time it's about 880, I think, gigabit. But the maximum, the real maximum load that really happened is about 710 gigabit per second, which is about 750,000 concurrent viewers at the same time, the same program. So about usually if a marketing session, I would say almost 800,000. We were at the same time seeing the same thing, which is actually a whole lot of the people. And the thing is that we survive. Our system is not down for a long time. I would admit that in some episode we down for a bit. We can quickly coming back up. So how did we survive this tsunami of viewer? Okay, first thing is that we do a lot of monitoring. Yeah, the picture show that the number of metrics that we are monitoring our server is about 1,000 per server. Currently, we have about almost 200,000 metrics being monitored all the time. I mean, usually it will be every 60 seconds. Yeah, we do a lot of monitoring even before the event. So when something happened, we know very very quickly that what is the bottleneck of the system, and we can get in and quickly fix it. The second thing is that because we use open source, most of the open source software usually can expose some kind of metrics to the monitoring system outside. Yeah, and we use and we create a lot of custom script to convert it, all those information and put it into our monitoring system. For the record, our monitoring system mainly based on Fabric, and we also monitor the health of each of the service, not just the things like CPU, memory, network. That all that are also being monitored. But we also monitor the health of each of the service on each of the edge server, on every server in our system. So if one server down, we can quickly failover to the others. And we can quickly zero in and bring out that server and replace it. Because at the time, we have to use some of the second-hand server, so it went up and down a lot. And the next thing is that because we use open source, we do not have to care much about the compliance hardware. We do not have to get the list of the hardware that compliance with all the software that we are running, because we build it ourselves. It can run anything. It can run on anything that is x86-64. And we at that time we use all kind of vendors, Supermicro, Dell, Asus, anything that we can have at that time. Even no brand is okay. The only thing that that we really need to care about is the brand of the network card, because it really affect a lot of performance. At the time, I think only Intel card can achieve the very high packet rate in the finger server. Yeah. And we use because we mainly use Debian distro at the time, is Debian 9, I think. Yeah. So we just need to make sure that the hardware compatible with Debian, which is actually most of the hardware already compatible with Linux, any Linux, not just Debian. Yeah. And although we bought a lot of kind of the servers into the same pool, we separate it into groups and do not make too many groups. So if something happened within one group, we can quickly snatch it out and replace it with something. So even if you can buy anything, just do not buy too many things, enough that you can manage. And the last thing is that we know our platform, because we build everything based on the open source, and we even build the things like, for example, Nginx. We use Nginx as the main HTTP server to serve the content. We build the binary version of the Nginx by ourselves, because we patch a lot of things into the Nginx, and we have our own repositories. So we hack a lot into the things that we think that is very important, and we do the tuning before we scale out. In my opinion, if we frantically scale out, it will cost a lot at the time. But we try to tune to make the one server to cover most of the as much squeeze all the performance that it can achieve within the server first, before scaling out. So we just only need about 30 to 50. I think the exact number is about 40 servers more to accommodate the load. And the last thing is that you need to focus on the majority of the users first. At the time, we first trying to maintain the viewer. At least viewer can see the content, but not HD. That is good enough for them. And the second thing is that they can see the streaming smoothly. That is enough. But actually, in the back end, all the analytics, accounting, everything is broken at the time of the TV program. We don't really care much about that, because we know that, well, the log files and everything is still intact. We can rerun the batch, everything after that. So the thing is that you need to focus on the important thing first, and let the other thing fail at the crisis time, and we can cover it up after the event. So that is end of my presentation. So if there is any question, you can come and ask me. I think maybe we already run out of time already. Thank you very much.